Hello friends, you are watching Tech Content English YouTube channel. This is Sarinath. Let's get into today's tech news. Moto has launched Moto G9 mobile, which is going to be the last mobile in Moto G9 family. We already have Moto G9, Moto G9 Plus. This Moto G9 power mobile has been launched in Europe. This will have 6000 mAh battery and the battery will last up to 60 hours. This mobile runs on stock Android 10. And this mobile will be available in selected countries of Asia, Latin America and Middle East. The price expected would be 17,000 for the 4GB RAM and 128GB variant. However, they have not clearly mentioned whether the mobile going to bring in India or not. The key features of the mobile includes display comes with 6.8-inch IPS LCD, chipset Snapdragon 662 SoC, RAM will be 4GB, storage will be 128GB, rear camera will have a triple, the primary sensor will be 64MP followed by 2MP and 2MP. Selfie camera comes with a 16MP, battery will carry 6000 mAh and it supports 20 watts fast charge. Coming to the next tech news, NCPI announcement. National Payment Corporation of India has set a cap of 30% of the UPI transaction amount can be processed by a single third-party app. This announcement will come into place from January 2021. Recently, UPI has seen over 2 billion of transactions, out of which Google Pay and Phone Pay has accounted majority of the transactions. To address the risk and to protect the UPI ecosystem, the NCPI has put this 30% cap by a single third-party UPI. This will largely affect the Google Pay and Phone Pay apps at present and give additional opportunity for the Paytm and MobiQuick. The UPI ecosystem is heavily dominated by Google Pay and Phone Pay companies. According to the recent reports, these two companies holding 40% of the transactions by each one of these. There is also concern keeping cap for the number of transactions in a month. It might lead to more payment failures. This market cap 30% has been calculated based on the last 3 months of the total UPI transactions and it will be on rolling basis for each month. It is unclear now that what will happen if the third party has reached 30% of the market cap. Whether the user will get any notification that you will not able to do the transactions or after doing the transactions, it might lead to errors or payment failures.
Next news on WhatsApp Pay. The National Payments Corporation of India, NPCI, announced today that WhatsApp can go ahead and roll out WhatsApp Pay in India. As per NPCI, WhatsApp allowed in a graded manner to start their services and maximum allowed 20 million registered users in UPI. Starting from January 2021, NPCI has announced that all third-party apps limit has been capped to maximum 30% of all their transactions in the future. According to the latest reports, Google Pay and Phone Pay both together occupied more than 40% of UPI transactions. So with the NPI cap limit, all this going to be a big impact to Google Pay and Phone Pay apps. Cap limit will be a challenging and need to see how many users are going to register against with each UPI system. Friends, how many of you are really interested to use WhatsApp when compared to other digital payments app like Google Pay, Phone Pay and Paytm apps? Please let me know in the comment section. Next news on Motorola. Motorola launched 3 new audio devices in India. Motorola Veru series audio products come with the IP65 rating. Let's get into the specifications. First model, Veru Buds 100. These are the two wireless headphones having 14 hours of battery life with a portable charging case. These headphones offer 3 different earbud gel size for the best fit. They are also equipped with a multifunctional touch button for managing calls, adjusting volume, changing songs, and also using for voice assistant. Buds 100 available through Amazon from November 10th onwards for the price of 2,699 rupees. Model WERTRAP 105. These are the flexible neckband style earphones are equipped with the 15mm speaker drivers. They offer up to 8 hours of music battery life and integrated with a mic for hands-free calling. The 105 model produces a deep bass for immersive music experience as per the company. The magnetic earbuds can also be locked together around the neck when not being used. WERTRAP 105 priced at 1699 and available on Amazon, Flipkart and other offline channels starting from today. And the last model, WERTLOOP 105. Motorola WERTLOOP 105 sports in-ear earphone offer up to 8 hours of battery life. The earphone is tangle-free cable with a magnetic buds and locked together around the neck. The company claims that these wireless earbuds are ideal for sports and gym use. They also have a built-in microphone for hands-free calling. This is exclusively available through Amazon for the price of 1,299 rupees. Next news on Lenovo. Lenovo has introduced new mobile which is called Lenovo K12 Note series in Saudi Arabia. Following are the key specifications: 6.5 inch HD plus IPS TFT display with 20:9 aspect ratio. It runs on Android 10, comes with the Snapdragon 662 SoC. It comes with a triple camera setup. Main camera is a 48 megapixel and 2MP macro camera and 2MP territory camera. We have a selfie shooter 8 megapixel sensor. It comes with the 4GB RAM and 128GB internal memory and expandable up to 512GB. It comes with a 5000mAh battery with supporting 20 watt fast charging. It also supports Bluetooth version 5, NFC, USB Type-C and also 3.5mm audio jack. Color variants, we have two options, forest green and sapphire blue. Currently available in Saudi Arabia. Priced at Saudi Arabia currency 599, roughly Indian currency around 12,000 it will come. We don't have any clarity whether they're going to launch in India or not. Next news on Google. As per latest news, Google is working on sending a messages by scheduling a time. The scheduled message feature by Google allowing users to choose date, time to send their text messages. After typing a message, users can select date, time and also predefined timings, or users can customize what time messages need to be sent. The latest Google APK file code included for the future. The new feature is not available to all the users. Currently rolled out only for the selected users, and very soon it's going to be rolled out to the worldwide. News on Sony. Sony A8H 4K HDR OLED TV launched in India, priced at 2,79,990 rupees. This support for Dolby Vision HDR. Following are the key specifications of Sony TV. It comes with the 65-inch OLED panel with the A8H Ultra HD HDR display. It supports for HDR to the Dolby Vision format. Maximum refresh rate to 120 GHz to Full HD resolution and 60Hz resolution at 4K. Sony TV comes with the X1 Ultimate Picture Processor. It supports built-in Chromecast, Google Assistant and Google Play Store for apps, and also support for Apple AirPlay 2. The television runs on Android. It comes with a 16GB internal storage for apps and data. The screen itself is the speaker using 4 drivers for total sound output of 30 watts. Premium competition for brands such as Samsung and LG, especially in OLED segment. Price at 2,79,990 rupees. Sony TV available through offline retail stores, major electronic stores, online portals of Sony and Amazon. That's all for today's tech news. If you like my video, Please subscribe, share, comment, and hit a bell icon to receive my further videos. Thanks for watching and hope to see you in my next video.